The Buddha's teaching. This is important. My teaching is not important. Buddha's teaching is important. So you should have enough faith in the Buddha's teaching. This is the Buddha's teaching now. Mahasatipatthana Sutta. You have already understood. In the beginning, as an introduction, Buddha says, the only way backwards is this path for the purification of beings, for the samadhi of sorrow and lamentation, for the disappearance of pain and grief, for the attainment of the noble path, for the realization of nibbana, namely the four foundations of mindfulness. M170, this is Majjhima Nikaya. There are three volumes. So this is number one volume, page number 17. According to 16th edition. What are the four? Number one. Here, bhikkhus, a bhikkhu abides contemplating the body in the body. Are they fully aware and mindful, having put away covetousness and greed for the world? He abides contemplating feelings and the feelings. Are they fully aware and mindful, having put away covetousness and greed for the world? Number three, he abides contemplating mind and the mind. Are they fully aware and mindful, having put away covetousness and greed for the world? Number four, he abides contemplating Dhamma objects and the Dhamma objects. Are they fully aware and mindful, having put away covetousness and greed for the world? This is the introduction of Mahasatipatthana Sutta. When Bright is saying Satipatthana, four foundations of mindfulness, you must have three types of quality. Number one, effort. You should have enough effort for the realization of Nibbana. Second, full awareness. You must try to understand your meditation object fully. If you understand your meditation object partially, it is impossible. Full awareness of your meditation object is very important. Then number three is mindful. You must always mindful. You must always remember your meditation object. You must establish your mindfulness on your meditation object always. So these three are very important. Number one, Oriya, effort. Number two, fully aware of clear comprehension. Number three, mindful. Then you must remove two important defilements. Number one, having put away covetousness. Number two, greed, unhappiness. While meditating, if you have a strong attachment to your sensual object, this is impossible for realization of nirvana. So you must put aside every attachment. Secondly, unhappiness. If there are many difficulties because of business, other than that, if you meditate, it is not easy to be successful. So unhappiness, you must remove one practicing meditation. So if there are four types of meditation subjects, bodily, you must contemplate the body, in the body, you must contemplate feelings and the feeling, you must contemplate mind and the mind, you must contemplate dhamma object and the dhamma object. So, kaya, varna, cheta, dhamma. Body, feeling, mind, and dhamma object. All together, four subjects. But if you practice one meditation, one session, for example, anapana session, literally according to Buddha's instruction, stage by stage, then you have already practiced four foundations of mindfulness. Satipatthana, Cattaro, Satipatthana. How? So please try to listen. Number one session in Mahasri Prana Sutta about Anapana meditation. Number one Samatha meditation, Buddha teach in Mahasri Prana Sutta about Anapana. Number two, Buddha teaches Vipassana meditation. So Samatha and Vipassana, Buddha teach stage by stage. So body contemplation, Kayanupassana. And how bhikkhus, that is bhikkhus, by contemplating the body and the body. Here a bhikkhu goes to the forest or to the root of a tree or to a secluded place, sits down, having folded his legs crosswise, sets his body erect, and having established mindfulness on his meditation object, ever mindful he breathes in, ever mindful he breathes out. So in this case, Buddha gave instruction suitable place for meditation. Number one, forest. Number two, the root of the tree. Or number three, secluded place. So you should choose this suitable place. Then when practicing anapana meditation, you should sit down. Sitting posture is best posture for higher concentration. Because of this reason, Buddha teach to sit down. But in every bodily posture, you can practice this anapana meditation. However, while practicing anapana, sitting posture is best posture for the attainment of jhana concentration, full absorption stage. So after sitting, you should fold your legs crosswise. So this is important. Then set your body erect. You must put erect. Finish is not good because the part of the breath is not straight. And then you cannot concentrate well. They have established mindfulness on his meditation object. You must establish your mindfulness on your meditation object. Do you understand? If you want to practice anapana, you should establish your mindfulness on your anapana object. If you establish your mindfulness in different objects, then this is no anapana meditation. Is it true? Because you are paying attention to different objects, so you will not say you are practicing anapana meditation. So if you want to practice anapana meditation, you should establish your mindfulness on your meditation object. This is anapana. Ever mindful, he breathes in, ever mindful, he breathes out. Then Buddha teaches another systematically, samatha meditation. Number one, breathing in love, he understands I breathe in love. Or breathing out love, he understands I breathe out love. Number two, breathing in short, he understands I breathe in short. On breathing up short, he understands I breathe up short. Number three, he thinks that I shall breathe in, experiencing the whole body of breath. He thinks that I shall breathe up, experiencing the whole body of breath. Number four, he thinks that I shall breathe in, tranquilizing the bodily formation. He thinks that I shall breathe out, tranquilizing the bodily formation. What is the meaning? The meaning of these four sentences. Number sentence 1 and 2. Here, long breath and short breath means the duration of time of the actual breath. Their length and shortness should be understood by itself. Adhana. If the meditator breathes slowly, that breath is called long. If the meditator breathes quickly, that breath is called short. That long or short breath should be known on the touching point only. That is on the nostril or upper lip only. However, the meditator must not intentionally try to make the breath either long or short. Please allow the breath to arise and fall in a natural way. This is very important. So, long breath and short may square on the nostril or upper lip. This is we call touching point. On the touching point, you should wait and see the breath. When it is long, you should try to understand this is long. When it is short, you should try to understand this is short. However, you should not try intentionally to make the breath either long or short. Please allow your breath in a natural way. This is very important. And sentence number 3, the whole body of breath. The whole body of breath means the beginning, middle, and end of the entire in-breath and out-breath. On the touching point only. That is on the nostril or upper lip only. It is not necessary to see the breath going through the whole body from head to foot. This is also very important. Some meditation teachers teach, in this case, to see the breath from head to foot, especially in United States. So they instruct the whole body of breath means they must follow from the head to foot. The breath is going through of the body. But in our Visuddhimagga commentary, you can see, please carefully note the following explanation. Pocha pocho kase vana satin chapeja va bhavanta seva bhavana sambhichati. This is very important. A bhikkhu must have the necessary mindfulness and understanding and must look for the in-breath and out-breath. Nowhere else there the place. That means the nostril or upper lip only. normally Dutch painting. However, this development is successful when he establishes his mindfulness deeply. That is the nose or upper lip for me. Touch by the breath. If he cultivates mindfulness of breathing in this way, then his meditation can be fully developed up to the attainment of jhana. This is Wisuddhi Magga, Volume 1, page number 271. This rule is very important. Because of this reason, why Frank is saying Anapana meditation, you must try to see only the breath, on the touching point. That is on the nose or upper lip for beginners. On the upper lip for nose only. So if you can watch your breath on the touching point only, then you can attain jhana. If you follow inside and outside, if you follow inside throughout the body, your mind will go throughout the body. This is because restlessness, weak hipa. If there is restlessness, concentration cannot be developed. So please do not follow throughout the body your breath. You should watch here on the nose ring only. On the nose ring, you must try to understand the breath from the beginning to the end. Beginning, the middle, and the end. So, fire begins only on the touching point only. Fire ends only on the touching point only. You should not search for anywhere, only this. You should fix one area. If the meditator has long nose, then the breath touches on the nostril. If the meditator's nose is short, like farming, then the breath touches on the upper lip. So you should watch where is very clear. On that clear point, you should watch and see the death breath only. From this point, you should not move your attention to anywhere. Then another is about nimitta. I want to explain about nimitta because some meditation teachers, they do not accept nimitta. Buddha never teach nimitta in many suttas. This is their argument. But in Parisamrita Magga, this is one Pali text. In Kotaka Nikaya. Kotaka Nikaya means there are five Nikayas. Number one is Higa Nikaya, long discourse. Number two is Vijima Nikaya, the middle discourse. Number three is Sanyogya Nikaya, connected saying. Number four is Engotra Nikaya, gradual saying. Number five is Kotaka Nikaya. They translate Kotaka Nikaya as miscellaneous Nikaya. Miscellaneous means in Kotaka Nikaya, Vinaya also under Kotaka Nikaya, Vijama also under Kotaka Nikaya. There are many different types of suttas also under Kotaka Nikaya, such as Dhammapada, Siddhiyodhaka, etc. So, in Kotaka Nikaya, Patisamita Magga is one volume. In Padisamrita Magga, Vinareva Sariputta says this sentence, Nimitta asasa pasasa anaramana mega chitasa ajana dhortiyo dhami bhavana nupa labhati. Padisamrita Magga, page number 169. Anapana chapter. What is the meaning? Sign, in-breath, out-breath are not objects of a single consciousness. By one who knows not these three things with a single consciousness, development is not obtained. What is the meaning? For beginners, number one, nimitta. Sign is no sign or abundant form for beginners because he did not yet see nimitta. Asada is infrared and pasada is operate. These three things are not the object of the single consciousness. The single consciousness simultaneously understands both in-breath in nimitta, lucy or apparent, or out-breath in nimitta, lucy or apparent. However, if the meditator does not know these three things with a single consciousness, with a single mind movement, then his meditation cannot develop up to the attainment of jhana. What is the meaning? If you want to understand the meaning, then please follow after. For that reason, the meditator must try to know these three things simultaneously with a single consciousness, with a single mind movement, for the attainment of jhana. How should he try? Prisamita Mega again says that Nimitta asasa pasasa anaramana meka chetasa janato chatiyo dhamme bhavana upalabhati. Same page. What is the meaning? Sign, in-breath, out-breath are not objects of a single consciousness. Development can be obtained by one who does not know these three things with a single consciousness. Development can be obtained. What is the meaning? When meditation improves and concentration on the natural breath, situated on the nose or upper lip becomes deeper and deeper, the nimitta sign will appear on the nose or upper lip. After dying, the meditator's contemplating mind focuses on the nimitta only, not on the breath. There are three types of nimitta. Number one, the great smoky gala nimitta, which is the preliminary sign, parikama nimitta. Number two, the white cotton wool gala nimitta, which is the nanay sign, kogaha nimitta. Number three, the translucent and bright nimitta, like the money star, which is the counterpart sign, patibhaga nimitta. Depending on a meditator's perception, there may also be different gala or different shaped nimitta. However, song is not the nimitta of anapanasana. Why? In America, some teachers teach, while concentration begins, they hear one type of song in the ear. They think this is the full absorption channel. In this way they teach. So there are different color, different shape in nimitta, but song is not nimitta. According to Buddha's teaching. So among these three types of nimitta sign, the counterpart sign is the object of anapana channel. Every time, number one, the nimitta sign is the anapana counterpart sign, anapana pratibhaga nimitta. Number two, the in-breath is also anapana counterpart sign. And number three, the out-breath is also anapana counterpart sign. Asasa pasasa nitaya upana nimitta pitta asasa pasasa samenya mewa. This is Visuddhi Magga Mahalinga, volume 1, page number 319. What is the meaning? Depending on the natural in-breath and out-breath, the nimitta sign appears because of deep concentration. Therefore, nimitta can also be called the in-breath and the out-breath. So, in-breath also nimitta, out-breath also nimitta, nimitta also nimitta. So these three are same at the end. Because of this reason, for that reason, when attaining jhana, that means at the actual moment of full absorption, a single consciousness or a single jhana-mind moment can take these three things, the nimitta, the embrace, and the object, as the object of jhana. Because at the jhana-mind moment, these three things are only one object, that is only anambana kondabhasa. This is the meaning of sentence 4. Vibhavani bhavmeshe kaya sankhara. Here means the embrace and outbreath. In the Engodra Nikaya, 9th chapter, Nupopa Nirota Sutta, in Engodra Nikaya, gradual sense, there are three volumes. Number 3 volume, page number 207. The Buddha says the in-breath and out-breath cease completely in the fourth jhana. Therefore, tranquilizing the bodily formation means the meditator must practice up to fourth jhana. So, in Mahasiddhana Sutra, Buddha also teaches samatha meditation. Many meditation teachers, they don't want to accept. Buddha teaches samatha in Mahasiddhana Sutra. This thing, Mahasri Brahma Sutta teaches only pure vipassana. This is their wrong teaching only. Buddha teaches up to fourth jhana only, but this system is very brief. Why? Listeners already understand what is the meaning, but nowadays many listeners, you may do not understand. So this is the difference. Because of this reason, when you enter up to the fourth jhana, at the actual full moment of full absorption, fourth jhana, full absorption stage, your breath completely stops. If you re-establish your fourth jhana, let's say for 1 hour, within 1 hour, your breath completely stops. Some meditators are afraid. Oh, one will die at the day. It is impossible. The power of fourth jhana concentration can maintain your body. Don't be worried. It is not necessary to be afraid of. Then the Buddha continues his teaching with an example. Just as a skilled jhana or his apprentice, when making a long time, understands I make a long time. Or when making a short time, understands I make a short time. So do breathing in long, he understands I breathe in long. Or breathing out long, he understands I breathe out long. Breathing in short, he understands I breathe in short. Or breathing out short, he understands I breathe out short. He thinks that I shall breathe in, experiencing the whole body of breath. He thinks that I shall breathe out, experiencing the whole body of breath. He thinks that I shall breathe in, tranquilizing the body formation. He thinks that I shall breathe out, tranquilizing the body formation. This is the Buddha's teaching in the Mahasiddhana Sutta. There may be some listeners who understand the meaning of this sentence, but there may be some meditators, they may do not understand clearly. So we will try to explain in brief way how a meditator develops concentration. To begin meditating, sit in a comfortable position and try to be aware of the breath as it enters and leaves the body through the nostrils. But the meditator should be able to feel it either just below the nose or somewhere around the nostrils. That is called the touching point. Do not follow the breath into the body or out of the body, because then he will not be able to perfect his concentration. just be aware of the breath, that the most obvious place is precious face or touches, either the top of the upper lip or around the nose area. Then he will be able to develop a perfect face concentration. After concentrating his mind like this, for at least half an hour, he should proceed to the first and second stage of the meditation. That is long breath and short breath. So first he should try to concentrate on the breath only. If he can concentrate for a few minutes or maybe 5 minutes, 10 minutes, it is a very good opportunity. It is not necessary to try counting breath. But if he cannot concentrate well, then he should try to count the breath. This is the suggestion of commentary. But without counting, if you can concentrate well on your breath object for about 10 minutes or 20 minutes, then you can proceed to start long, to understand the long breath and short breath. When it is long, you should try to understand this is long. When it is short, you should try to understand this is short. However, please do not know this is long or this is short. If you want to know, then you should know only prepare only. Why? One friend is saying concentration is very important. You should not investigate whether it is really long or whether it is really short. If you investigate this way, in this way, then the enlightenment factor of investigation becomes excessive. When it is excessive, concentration will decrease. So because of this reason, please simply note, prepare only. But when it is long, you should try to understand it is long. If you understand it is enough, it is not necessary to know this is long. When it is short, you should try to understand it is short, but please do not know this is short. If you understand, it is enough. At this stage, he has to develop awareness of whether the in and out breath are long or short. Long or short here does not refer to length in feet, in inches, but length in time, the duration. He should decide for himself what length of time he will call long and what length of time he will call short. Be aware of the duration of each in and out breath. He will notice that the breath is sometimes long in time and sometimes short. Just knowing this is all he has to do at this stage. Do not note in of long, in of short. Just be aware of whether the breath are long or short. He should know this by seeing just aware of the length of time that the breath brushes against and touches the upper lip or around the nose as it enters and leaves the body. Sometimes the breath may be long throughout the sitting and sometimes short, but do not purposely try to make it long or short. Throughout sitting, if it is long, no problem. Throughout sitting, when it is short, it is also no problem. If you understand throughout the breath, it is enough. And this is for some meditators, the nimitta may appear. But if he is able to do this calmly for about 1 hour and no nimitta appears, he should move on to the third stage, that is experiencing the whole body of breath. If he is calmly aware of the breath from beginning to end for about 1 hour and no nimitta appears, he should move on to the fourth stage, that is tranquilizing the body formation. To do this, he should decide to make the breath tranquil and go on being continuously aware of the breath from beginning to end. Visual movement to the that experience in the whole body of breath. So, when breath is in the to understand the whole body of breath from the beginning to the end, it is also not necessary to know this is the beginning, this is the middle, this is the end. If you want to know, please know only simply breathing in, breathing out only. But throughout the whole breath, you must try to understand. When it is long, you should try to understand the whole body of breath. When it is short, you should try to understand the whole body of breath. Naturally, as I said, when concentration develops, the breath becomes subtle. This is natural. At this stage, the image may appear, but if he is able to do this calmly for about 1 hour, 1 hour and no image appears, he should move on to the fourth stage, tranquilizing the bodily formation. When the breath becomes very calm, other than you should not try to make the breath clear. Please concentrate on that. Calm breath, subtle breath. Subtle breath is very good. Why? Very soon nimitta will appear. When nimitta appears, you must focus on the nimitta. As a day, when the breath is very clear, then sometimes you may be able to concentrate on the nimitta. Sometimes you may be able to concentrate on your breath. So there may be two objects. If there are two objects, your concentration cannot improve. Because of this reason, when the breath becomes subtle, it is very good opportunity. You should not try to make the breath clear or to make the breath cross. If you try in this way, your effort becomes excessive. When effort is excessive, restless mind will appear. Concentration will decrease. Because of this reason, please allow your breath in the natural way. While concentrated on the whole breath body, whether it is long or short. At that time, when the breath becomes subtle, you should try to concentrate on the subtle breath. At that time, strong, powerful mindfulness. Strong, powerful, full awareness is necessary. Full awareness is necessary. If you want to use very subtle needle, then there must be another needle to dig a hole. This is necessary in the same way. When the breath becomes very subtle, other than strong, powerful mindfulness and strong, powerful awareness is very important. And then please increase your mindfulness. Please penetrate to know the subtle breath. If you do in this way, slowly your concentration will improve. And then to do this, he should decide to make the breath tranquil and go on being continuously aware of the breath from beginning to end. He should do nothing else, otherwise his concentration will break and fall away. The Visuddhi Magga gives four factors for making the breath tranquil. Number one, constant avoca. Number two, reaction. Samanahara. Number three, attention, manasikara. Number four, reviewing, pichapakana. These four factors are necessary. So all he needs to do at this stage is to decide to tranquil the breath. When the breath is very cross, And then the meditator must be said, my breath must be tranquil. But it is in any, he should not try to breathe very, very smoothly. If he do, then concentration will be clear. Because of this reason, please allow in the natural way. But at the beginning of sitting, my breath must be tranquil. In this way, you should be set. That decision is enough. Then please concentrate on your natural breath. Slowly, the breath will be constructed. So all he needs to do at this stage is to decide to tranquil the breath and to be continuously aware of it. That way he will find the breath becomes more tranquil and the nimitta may appear. Just before the nimitta appears, a lot of yogis encounter difficulties. Mostly they find that the breath becomes very subtle and unclear. They may think the breath has stopped. If this happens, he should keep his awareness where he last noticed the breath and wait for it there. So, when the breath disappears, they should wait and see on the previous checking point, closely or opposite. From this point only wait. But there is still very subtle, very gentle breath is still there. So because of this reason, you are still breathing. There are only seven persons who do not breathe. Among seven persons, you are not included. Because they are dead persons, you are not yet dead. In mother's womb, you are not yet in mother's womb. It has taken off breath. Then unconscious persons taking off breath. You are still conscious, not unconscious man. Fourth jhana attainment. Within fourth jhana attainment, taking off breath. No, you have not yet attained fourth jhana. Then cessation attainment, niradas mahapati. Within cessation attainment, there is no breath. Completely stop. But you are not yet attained cessation attainment. And then Brahma also do not free. That's not free. You are not yet Brahma. So because of this reason, still you are breathing because of weakness of your mindfulness and awareness. You cannot free the breath of me. So just focus on the touching point and upper lip. Then you will feel breath very quickly. When it is subtle, he should not make the breath more obvious, as the effort will cause agitation and his concentration will not develop. Just be aware of the breath as it is, and if it is not clear, simply wait for it where he does notice it. He will find that as he applies his mindfulness and wisdom in this way, the breath will reappear. Here the Buddha is instructing the meditator to be aware of the whole breath from beginning to end. As he does this, the nimitta may now appear. If it does, do not immediately shift the mind to it, but stay with the breath. Why? For beginners, when the nimitta appears, usually nimitta is not stable. Why? Concentration is not yet deep enough to maintain the nimitta. Because of this reason, if they quickly shift to the nimitta, then nimitta will disappear. For some meditators, light is appear first. For some meditators, nimitta appear first. Why? It's based on their parami. When their parami is very mature, then when they are concentrated on the breath of the very quickly nimitta appears together with breath. But when their parami is a little bit far away, then they must try hard. Because between their parami, between the one type of existence where they establish their parami, in this very life, there are many defilements, then they cannot concentrate well thoroughly, so they must kind heart. But in one of previous life, very close to this very life, if they had practiced anabana meditation thoroughly, then when they are concentrating on the natural breath, very soon breath will become limited very quick. So it depends on varmi. Because of this reason, if you focus on your nimitta very, very quickly, then because concentration is not yet deep enough to maintain this nimitta, then nimitta will disappear very quickly. So the best way is you should focus only just breath. Breath and nimitta must be together, coming out from your nose field. At that time, your concentrated mind will stick to the nimitta automatically, because the nimitta and breath are together. And then you can focus only just nimitta. And then breath also very, very subtle. Because of this, they say, while focusing on your nimitta, you will forget your breath. But still, you are breathing. However, you do not pay attention to your breath. You pay attention only nimitta. Because of this reason, you can thoroughly concentrate on your nimitta. So the nimitta of anapanasati varies according to the individual yogi. To some, the nimitta is pure and fine like cotton wool or drum of cotton, moving air or a drop. A bright light like the morning star Venus, a bright ruby or gem, or a bright paper. To others, it is like the skin of a cotton plant or a sharpened piece of wood. To yet others, it is like a long rope or string, a wreath of flowers, a puff of smoke, a stretch of cobweb, a film of mist, a lotus, a cherry of wheat, a moon or a sun. In most cases, a pure white nimitta like cotton wool is the ogaha nimitta, taking up sign or learning sign. It is usually dull and opaque. When the nimitta becomes bright like the morning star, brilliant and clear, it is the pratibhaga nimitta counterpart sign. The other images should be understood in this way too. So even though anapanasati is a single meditation subject, it produces various types of nimitta. The nimitta appears differently to different people. Thus, the nimittas are different because of perception. When perception changes, nimitta also changes. Especially for those who can concentrate well on the nimitta. At that time, if they can concentrate more than 1 hour, 2 hours, etc. in every city, then if they change their perception, the nimitta will be changing. For example, if they want to see red color nimitta at that time, then nimitta will become red. If they want to see yellow color nimitta, then nimitta will become yellow. But this is for those who have enough concentration on. For beginners, it is impossible. If they want to see round nimitta, then nimitta will become round. If they want to see long nimitta, then nimitta will become long. So if the meditator tries in this way, slowly concentration will decrease. Why? This is a very important rule. On the touching point, if you can concentrate on your breath, at that time only your concentration can develop up to the attainment of full absorption stage. But if you move your attention from the touching point to another area, then your concentration cannot develop, you cannot attain jhana. So this is very important. Because of this reason, please don't try to make the breath long or short, or to make the nimitta long or short, or maybe to make the nimitta different color. If the color is changing, then concentration slowly will become decreased. So when concentrating on the nimitta, anapana kondapa sign, to avoid dropping into bhunga and to develop further, he needs to the help of the five controlling faculties to push the mind and fix it on the anapana kondapa sign, padibhaga nimitta. The five controlling faculties are number one, faith, satya, number two, effort, vriya, number three, mindfulness, sati, number four, concentration, samadhi, number five, wisdom faculty, jnana, which penetrates anapana counterpart side. So the five controlling faculties are the five powers that control the mind and keep it from the screen of the path of samatha, tranquility, and vipassana inside. That leads to nibbana. If one or more of the controlling faculties are in excess, there will be a balance. When the five controlling faculties are sufficiently developed and balanced, concentration will go beyond excess up to jhana, full absorption concentration. When he reaches jhana, his mind will know the padibhaga nimitta without interruption. This can continue for several hours, even all night or for a whole day. When his mind is still concentrated on the anapana padibhaga nimitta for 1 or 2 hours or more, he should try to discern the bhavanga mind door and the anapana padibhaga nimitta together. When the bhavanga mind door is bright and luminous, which is situated at the area in the heart, when he sees nimitta appear in the bhavanga mind door, he can discern five jhana patterns. But this is a very interesting one. In Gudra Nikaya, there is one sutra, there is one chapter, Ishra Sangata chapter. In that chapter, Buddha teaches Bhava Sara Mitram Bhikkhu Chaita. Because this Bhunga Chaita is luminous and bright. This commentary explains, is there any color in mind? Mind has any color. Do you understand? Has any color? No. Mind is just consciousness and mental factors only. They have no color. Color is the rupa, materiality, not mentality. Why Buddha teaches in this way? Sometimes Buddha teaches the Dhamma metaphorically. Please try to see me. Do you see me? By what? By what do you see me? Is it true? Do you see with your eyes to me? Is it true? Is it true? Not true. This is metaphorical. Eye consciousness arises when your eyes translucent element. That eye consciousness only see. For example, if you close your eyes, but there is still eye translucent, but you cannot see. Why? Why is eye consciousness cannot arise when you close your eyes? If you open your eyes at the time, if there is also enough light at the time, only eye consciousness can arise when on your eyes. At the time, you can see this color. However, I see you by my eye consciousness. For example, if you say, then they will laugh. They will not accept. Naturally, they use, I see by my eye. You do not use I see, find, mind and consciousness. Is it true? Yes. In this way, in the same way, Buddha also speaks his Dhamma metaphorically. What is the reason? Every consciousness which arises within on your heart face can produce mind boom, materiality mind boom, kalapas. One mind boom can produce uncountable mind boom, kalapas. If you analyze each kalapa, there are 9 types of materiality, such as earth element, water element, fire element, wind element, color, odor, flavor, nutritive essence, nutritive essence. Among these 8 types, there is color. That color is luminous and bright. But not only one kalapa, there are one type, one mind movement can produce uncountable mind form kalapa. So within one finger snap, uncountable mind movement arise and pass away. Every mind movement can produce uncountable mind form kalapa. So within one finger snap, there are uncountable mind form kalapa. They arise closely to each other. Among those kalapas, in every kalapa there is kala. One kalapa's kala, another kalapa's kala, combined together, begin luminous and bright. Again, in each mind boom kalapa, there is fire element, tejo, dhatu. That fire element is called temperature, udu. That temperature also can produce new generation, new kalapas. In each kalapa of mind boom kalapa, there is fire element. Every fire element produces many generations of temperature boom kalapa. In those kalapas, there is also color. So, combination of the mind boom kalapa's color and temperature boom kalapa's color becomes this luminous mirror. Like mirror inside the heart. That mirror is also called manjo, metaphorically. So that Bhoinga mindset also arises within on heart face. That Bhoinga mindset also can produce mind bone kalapa. In each mind bone kalapa, there is also fire element. That fire element also can produce new generation, new kalapa. So combination of these 2 types of kalapas, mind boom kalapas kala and temperature boom kalapas kala, because luminous mirror. That luminous mirror metaphorically is called Manodwara Maido. That Maido is very important. If you want to listen Jhana Pata, then you must discern this Paripada Nimitta, counterpart sign, and this Nishokesam Bhoinga Maido. As soon as you emerge from Jhana, then this Anapana counterpart sign will appear in your Maido, and then you get discern Jhana Pata. For beginners, usually we teach to discern Jhana Pata one by one. For clear understanding, but if they can discern verily, then we teach to discern right together. So what are five Jhana Petas? Now you can see here, number 1, obligation vicheka. Directly embracing the mind on the anapana counterpart side, anapana pribhaga nimitta. Number 2, sustaining vichara. Maintaining the mind on the anapana pratibhaga nimitta. Number 3 is joy of rapture, piti. Lagging for the anapana pratibhaga nimitta. Number 4, bliss or palasya, sukha. Happiness about the anapana pratibhaga nimitta. Number 5, work-pointedness, jigga-gita, one pointedness of mind only, anapana, paribhasa, nimitta. So this five dhyana pradas arise. And the actual moment of full absorption, there are not only these five dhyana pradas, but also there are other mental formations which are associated with this, these five dhyana pradas. At the first jhana mind moment, there are only four types of mental formations. They are, please try to see. Number one, consciousness, change. Mental patterns, universal seven. Wonder, feeling, perception, volition, one-pointedness, life, totality, attention. Occasional, six. Application, sustainment, decision, energy, joint or rupture, desire, beautiful, universal, faith, sadhana, mindfulness, sati, conscience, theory, shame, or dhamma, no greed, aloha, no hatred, and also ever evenness, sadhana, mitta, sadhana, tranquility of mental body, Kaya Vasadi, tranquility of consciousness, Chitya Vasadi, lightness of mental body, Kaya Lahuda, lightness of consciousness, Chitya Lahuda, plentivality of mental body, Kaya Mududa, plentivality of consciousness, Chitya Mududa, willingness of mental body, Kaya Gaminyada, weakness of consciousness, Chitta Gaminyada, proficiency of mental body, Kaya Bhagunyada, proficiency of consciousness, Chitta Bhagunyada, attitude of mental body, Kaya Chukata, attitude of consciousness, Chitta Chukata, no delusion, wisdom faculty. Total mental formations 34. So these 34 are very important. One practice we must not these 34 only. You must try to accumulate these 34 again and again, they will become powerful. That powerful 34 can be jhana, can be vipassana. Then later can be part in provision knowledge. So these 34 are very important. But one friend is in jhana, these five jhana fetters are predominant fetters. Because of this reason, the combination of these jhana fetters are called jhana only. Each one is called jhananga, jhana mental fetter only. But tied together are called jhana. So many meditators, they misunderstand how jhana can fly in the sky. Jhana is flying in the sky. They think, no, jhana is combination of this tied together are called jhana. One by one is jhananga, jhana fetter. But I want to explain here noble eightfold path. This noble eightfold path is very important. One practice is a matter of meditation. At the actual moment of full absorption, there are also noble eightfold path. They are, number one, right view, which penetrates the anapana counterpart, samadhi. Right intention, samasankappa. Application of the mind to the anapana counterpart. Right effort, samavayama. Right effort for higher concentration for full absorption of anapana counterpart. Right mindfulness of right mindfulness, samasati. The right mindfulness is always remembering the anapana counterpart. Right concentration on the anapana counterpart only. Samadhi, all together they are five fetters. Before practicing the matter of meditation, the meditator already undertakes morality, which are Number six, right speech, samavacha. Number seven, right action, samakamada. Number eight, right livelihood, samajiva. What you get there are noble eightfold path, adhipatthana, my moment. When practicing samatha also there are altogether noble eightfold path. But morality, right speech, right action, right livelihood, they are not associated with the 34. They arise separately only, 34 janatama. They arise separately only in Monday 1. One brand is in Vipassana also same. Before one brand is in Vipassana, every meditator must undertake 5 precepts or 10 precepts, etc. Other than that, right action, right speech, right action, and right livelihood are associated, are present. They do not associate with Vipassana inside, within one mind movement. They arise separately. But when they realize Nibbana as they die, this 34 plus these 3 morality training, they arise together, all together they are 37. So when practicing samatha meditation, there are also noble eightfold path. In meditation must develop this mundane, this is also one type of mundane, noble eightfold path. In meditation must cultivate this mundane, noble eightfold path. Supra-mundane, noble eightfold path has only one. It is impossible to develop. So you must develop this mundane, noble eightfold path. Again, one practice in Vipassana also in the same way they are. Noble eightfold path. These noble eightfold path, when practicing Vipassana, are also called mundane noble eightfold path. That mundane noble eightfold path you must develop. You can cultivate this mundane noble eightfold path. Supra mundane noble eightfold path, which realize Nibbana, rise only once. Because of this, then it is not easy to develop. So you must cultivate or you must develop mundane noble eightfold path only. So in Mahatri Prana Sutta, Buddha teaches this noble eightfold path also. Then he shall continue to practice second jhana, but jhana in fourth jhana according to procedure which are mentioned in the Visuddhi Magga. Now I want to explain briefly. There are Padmasari. Whenever you want to discern jhana pratas, you must try to discern very, very quickly. That discerning jhana pratas, they separate two types of maskari. Number one is avachana vasi. Number two is pichavakana vasi. If you are practicing mentality meditation, namakamadhana, if you can discern this 34 or 33, such as this mental formations, other than you will understand clearly. This is mental cognitive process. While you are reviewing or reflecting jhana pratas, this is also mental cognitive process. And the mental cognitive process, there may be 8 types of consciousness. Number one is mental advancing consciousness. Number two is impartial. First jhana, second jhana, third jhana, fourth jhana, fifth jhana, sixth jhana, and seventh jhana, etc. Only. So these 7 jhanas are one type of mind movement. Mind advancing consciousness. Then mind advancing consciousness also can discern these 5 jhana pratas. This is called avachana vasi. Then after mind advancing consciousness, there are 7 jhanas. For some meditators, 5 jhanas only. Then these jhanas also can discern these 5 jhana pratas. So this is called Pitcha Vakana Upasthiti. So only within 1 week, one cognitive process, this separately called Avodana Upasthiti and Pitcha Vakana Upasthiti. But for beginners who are still, who are now practicing Samatha only, they do not differentiate these two mastery. Because of this reason, we teach if the meditator can listen very, very quickly, this dana better, this enough. How quick? Within 1 second or 2 seconds, they can see this dana better, it is enough. Then another is, whenever you want to enter into jhana, you must try to enter into jhana within 1 minute or within 1 second or 2 seconds, etc. Whenever you want to emerge from jhana, you should try to emerge from jhana. Why? Some meditators, if they enter into jhana, they cannot come up from jhana very quickly. It is not easy for them to come up from jhana. Their concentration is very deep. They cannot easily go up from jhana. So because of this reason, one brand is in vipassana. If they cannot come up from jhana, it is not easy to contemplate this jhana dhammas as nicca, dukkha, and anatta very, very quickly. Because of this reason, they must try maskari. No? Whenever they want to emerge from jhana, they should try to emerge from jhana. Another is to maintain concentration. For vipassana, they must enter into jhana. As soon as they enter into jhana, then they must come up from jhana very quickly, and they must contemplate jhana dhammas as nicca, dukkha, anatta. In this way, they must do very, very quickly. But if they cannot do like that, then kaya vipassana cannot become mature. Because of this reason, they should do short dhyana. Within 1 minute, they can emerge to come up from jhana. Or within 1 second, you come up from jhana, etc. But for beginners, we must do a dhyana, strong determination for 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, it is better. Because they are not yet practicing vipassana, they are maintaining their concentration for a long time. At that time only, their concentration will become deeper and deeper. Because of this reason, we suggest for beginners to maintain their concentration for 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours or more. In every sitting, if they can maintain their concentration more than 3 hours, at the time usually we teach second jhana. However, there are also some old meditators. They cannot maintain for 3 hours. So at that time we must teach them, if you can maintain more than 2 hours or more than 1 hour, then we teach second jhana. But usually, if they can stay in 5 jhana for about at least 3 days or 4 days, 5 days, it is better. If they could reach, go to second jhana, higher jhana, then their concentration is not so good. They cannot maintain higher jhana also for a long time. If they can maintain 5 jhana for a long time, when they go to second jhana, they can also maintain second jhana for a long time. If they can maintain second jhana for a long time, when they go to 3 jhana, they can maintain 3 jhana for a long time. If they can maintain 5 jhana for a long time, when they go to 4 jhana, they can maintain their concentration for a long time. So because of this reason, at least 3 days or 4 days, 5 days, they should maintain their concentration in each jhana. If they want to go to second jhana, how? This 5 mastery is very important. If they can maintain their concentration in every sitting for about 2 or 3 hours, at the time, if they want to go to second jhana, then they should re-establish their 5 jhana concentration for about 1 hour. When they emerge from 5 jhana, they should review or reflect 2 disadvantages and 1 advantage. What can do this Prabhupada? This Prajna is close to the enemy hindrances. This is one disadvantage. Why it is close? When a meditator can concentrate on the Anapana counterpart centrally, at that time only five hindrances will not visit to their mind. Before that stage, occasionally this one or two or many hindrances will visit to their mind. Because when they at the actually excess concentration stage, upachara samadhi, and then there only five hindrances will not visit to their mind. Excess concentration in jhana, full absorption concentration, they are very close to each other. Because of this reason, hindrances are also very close to this jhana. This is one disadvantage. Another disadvantage is please reflect. Paijanapetas, among Paijanapetas, Vijaga and Vichara. Application and sustainment. If you do not apply your mind to the your Anapana counterpart, your concentration will decrease. If you cannot sustain your concentration, then your mind on your Anapana counterpart, then concentration will decrease. However, without applying, without sustainment, without obligation, if you can maintain your concentration, it will be very good. So applying again and again, this is gross manner of mind. Because of this reason, these vijagas in which are obligation and sustainment are gross. This is one disadvantage. Then you should review another advantage. Please reflect. Piti, sukha, ekagata. Piti, rapcha, sukha, palasha, and ekagata, one consciousness. They are very, very peaceful. This is one advantage. After reflecting in this way, with the intention for the attainment of higher jhana, second jhana, you should concentrate on the nimitta. However, that reviewing two disadvantages and one advantage must be very, very short. Within few seconds, you should try to review these two disadvantages and one advantage. If you are reviewing it takes a long time, then you may have disappear. Because of this reason, within few seconds, you must try to finish this reviewing. Then please concentrate on the nimitta. Very soon, full absorption may arrive. For beginners, this full absorption may be prajna only. But for those who have already experienced second jhana, then they may go directly. Then the meditator must stay in full absorption for 2 or 3 minutes. Imagine from that full absorption, while reviewing jhana patterns, at that time only he will see ujjaka, vichara, obligation and sustainment are very gross. Piti, sukha, ekagata, rapsha, palesha, and one-pointedness. These three jhana patterns are very, very peaceful. At that time, with the intention to remove gross patterns and to achieve peaceful patterns, which is second jhana. The meditator must concentrate on the nimitta, anapana counterpart sign. Then very soon full absorption will arise. That full absorption may be second jhana. If it is really second jhana, then meditator will understand vijaga, vichara, obligation and sustainment disappear. Only 3 jhana patterns, piti, sukha and ekagata, raksha, palesha, and one point remain. If it is so, then he should maintain this second jhana, 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hour, etc. And then he should practice 5 maskari, at least 4 or 5 days. If he is satisfied, if he wants to go to Vajjana, then He should stay in first jhana for few minutes only. He should stay in second jhana for 1 hour. Even in front of second jhana, then he should review again in the same way. Two disadvantages and one advantage. Two disadvantages are, this second jhana is close to the enemy first jhana. In other words, the enemy of Vujjaka, Vujjhara, application and sustainment. Then please review again PT. PT is rupture or joy. That joy or rupture produces a lot of emotion. Is it true? When the object is, if you please one object very, very clearly, then emotion will arise. So this is a gross manner. Because of this reason, please review PT is cross. Then please review again Sukha Ekagatara. Pleasure is 1.89. These two jhana pradas are very, very peaceful. So after reviewing these two disadvantages and one advantage, with the intention for the attainment of that jhana, you should concentrate on your nimitta only. One concentration on the nimitta, very soon full absorption will arise. That full absorption for beginners may be second jhana again. For experts who have experience, they can directly go. But for beginners, maybe second jhana. Then they should stay in, you should stay in second jhana. That will get second jhana for about 2 or 3 minutes. Imagine from second jhana, point. Reviewing jhana pedas, you will see PT is very cross. Sukha ekagata, pleasure in 1.7. They are very, very peaceful. Embedded with the intention to remove gross pedas, PT, and to achieve peaceful pedas, sukha in ekagata. This is the jhana. You should concentrate on the nimitta. Full absorption will arise very quickly. That full absorption may be tatjana. If it is really tatjana, then meditator will understand. Piti disappears. Then there is only sukha in ekagata. Malaysia in 1.7 only. Then if it is so, then the meditation may take this jhana for 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, etc. When maintaining this jhana, you should stay in every sentence, you must start jhana. First jhana, you can stay 2 or 3 minutes. Second jhana, 2 or 3 minutes. Then start jhana for it. Okay. If you are satisfied, other than if you want to go to fourth jhana again, you should re-establish this Pachana concentration for about 1 hour. Imagine from Pachana full absorption, then you can review or you can reflect two disadvantages and one advantage in the same way. Two disadvantages, number one is this Pachana is close to the enemy PG. This is one of second jhana pada. Then please review sukha. Sukha is also very cross. One, if the object is very, if there is happiness or pleasure to any object, then little bit mind is little bit shaken, enjoying this object. So because of this reason, this is also gross pada. Then please review upekha ekagata. Upekha is equanimous feeling. And then ekagata 1.9. These two jhana padas are very peaceful. After reviewing in this way, please concentrate on the anapana counterpart sign with the intention for the attainment of fourth jhana. However, for beginners, when four absorption appear again, this four absorption may be Satyana Bhoomi. You can stay in that jhana for few minutes, 2 or 3 minutes. Imagine from that jhana, coming out from that jhana, you should review jhana pradas. When reviewing jhana pradas, at that time you will see sukha is very gross. Upaka, ikagra, two jhana pradas are very peaceful. At that time with the intention to remove gross pradas and to achieve peaceful pradas, this is fourth jhana. You should concentrate on the nimitta. One concentration on the nimitta, very soon full absorption may rise. That full absorption may be fourth jhana. If it is really fourth jhana, then you will understand sukha is there. Only equanimous feeling, equanimity and one-pointedness. There are two jhana pradas are remaining. Then you should maintain this fourth jhana concentration for a long time. 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, etc. When maintaining this fourth jhana concentration, you must start in every sitting from first jhana. In first jhana, you should stay 2 or 3 minutes, second jhana 2 or 3 minutes, first jhana 2 or 3 minutes. Then you can maintain your fourth jhana concentration for a long time. At the time, you should not investigate whether I'm breathing or not. Because this investigating brain can produce very subtle breath. When actually, if you are entering into fourth jhana, at that time no breath. However, if you imagine from jhana, fourth jhana, if you investigate, that investigating brain produce very, very subtle breath. So because of this reason, many meditators, they have a lot of doubt in this case, because this is a little bit subtle breath. So today, maybe now 9 o'clock, I want to stop my tomato here, but you can discuss, opening no problem. You can ask many questions. Please do CLA. Please do CLA. Then you can practice mentality meditation. Then at that time you will understand clearly. For beginners, it is not easy to differentiate. This is the mind of advanced consciousness which review jhana pradas. This is impartial jhana mind moment which reviews jhana pradas. This is not differentiate. But when they practice mentality meditation, at that time they get attention. Okay.
You mentioned just now, review of third jhana. How many jhana factors are there in the third jhana? Because I heard you mentioning Upeka.
Third jhana, two.
Two.
Sukha, ikagra.
If after we emerge from the first jhana, after emerging from first jhana, I want to go to second jhana. If we after investigating the
after investigation, can we straight away go to second jhana?
Go
it
to the true form?
This is for this part. Please try to begin this part. what we suggest to review every channel, it is better. Surely they will become inspired.
Reviewing the five jhana factors is done outside the jhana, is that correct?
Yes. Mm. Because this is reviewing knowledge, not jhana knowledge. Mm. Mm.
So, you mentioned sitting posture is the best that is this kind of understanding. Is that explanation or is just a matter of time?
Hmm?
Is there some explanation to it, or is it just a matter of fact?
Maybe for beginners, sitting posture is very good, but for experts, not necessary to be basic. Narayana Moglana fighting with dragon, huh? Nando Bananda dragon, he is not sitting. If he is sitting, then dragon will attack to him. So for his first they can do any way, but for beginners only. Beginners sitting posture is very good for higher concentration. No question?
Several just now mentioned about the jhana factors. When a person is in third jhana, they have to come out from the jhana to view the jhana factors. So after that, they have to go back to the Nimitta. So does it mean that they go back straight to the third jhana again, or they have to go first jhana, second jhana, and then go back?
Maybe when reviewing, for example, if they had already attained third jhana, if they want to review jhana filters, as long as they emerge from third jhana, they should review. After that, only they can see jhana filters. But for few seconds later, if they review, they cannot see. So very quickly they must do. As long as they emerge, very, very quickly they do. They should try to review jhana filters. But if it is not clear, then please re-establish the jhana concentration. May be possible for some meditators. But if it is not okay, then go back to first jhana filter. First jhana few minutes, second jhana few minutes, inside jhana, or at least 1 hour, it is better. And then, as soon as they emerge from jhana, they can review this jhana better, very quickly. Before meditating, they should do data. So from determination, may my Vajrayana concentration last long for 1 hour or 2 hours, etc. Then while practicing, they should do nothing. Then if their decision, so from determination is true, true means become true, then they may emerge when it is 1 hour, when it is 2 hours, etc. When meditating, they should do nothing. Before meditating, we must do this dhyana. You can do this dhyana to become Siali also said. Temporary. Do this kind of coming, it is also possible.
Pardon? In the fourth jhana, you mentioned that the breathing stops. Does the breathing really stop, or is it because the breath is so subtle that does the breathing really stop in the top jhana?
It
stops.
Yes, it includes that nikaya. There is new bhoma niroda sutta. In that new bhoma niroda sutta, in both jhana, the breath completely ceases, and this way Buddha teaches. So complete cessation.
Okay, and in, when the breathing really stops, the brain is still okay.
Don't worry, it's still working. Because of the power of jhana kusala, higher concentration. Beginners, it is not easy, means because of body only. So they should focus only on the nursery or abundance. This is best way. If they follow through of the body, concentration cannot be deep enough for academy of jhana. When they are reviewing from one part to another, mind is going from one part to another. So if they are going in this way, mind cannot be concentrated mind, only just reviewing mind. No question? Buddha says, full awareness, fully awareness. This is also important. Full awareness of the meditation object. This is also one type of wise meditation. So there are three bhajas, again, the form of full alpha. Fully awareness, this is sambhajana, this is one type of wise meditation. Then mindfulness. These three bhajas are necessary. You must remove every attachment, covetousness, and then greed, the unhappiness. But this is only for example. All unwholesome dhammas you must remove. They are legal. Sadha, faith or confidence is very weak. Then you should read suttas, which will encourage you to increase faith. Or you should listen to mantra, which will increase your faith. Or you should discuss with each other, who will encourage you to increase faith. This is one. Then viriya. The strong bubble effort is necessary. This effort is very weak. and you should review UFO sickness, UFO death, or sickness, death, etc. And then that coming future suffering in woeful state. Lazy persons are usually after that they must go to one of woeful states. The strong, powerful effort man, what is effort? To remove a host of the mud which had already risen. To increase host of the mud which are not yet risen. To increase host of the mud which had already risen. So this potential effort is necessary. Now you are not yet adding jhana. I will try to adding jhana. And this way you must increase your effort. After reviewing poorness, sickness in this very life and death. After death, we must go to another mother's womb. So inside mother's womb, there may be many suffering. Or maybe we may go to one of woeful states. There are many suffering. So, to escape from these different kinds of suffering, lazy person is impossible. Only the strong powerful effort, who has the strong powerful effort, can escape from these suffering. So you must do, in this way, you should encourage within oneself. This is Guriya, no? That's how we are sitting mindfulness. To increase mindfulness, you must pay attention again and again to your meditation object. Then, samadhi concentration. You must intentionally try to concentrate on your meditation object only. At that time, concentration will increase. Then, pinya wisdom faculty. One practice in samadha, pinya is very weak. Not so strong, powerful, no very high. Penetrating the nimitta or knowing the nimitta or penetrating the nimitta, this is only wisdom faculty. So, for attainment of wisdom faculty, concentration is very important. Samadhi bhikkhu bhavita, samadhi bhikkhu bhikkhu yata buddha bhajanati, bhikkhu develop concentration. The concentration makes us understand the dhamma as they really are. So concentration can produce this nimitta. At that time, wisdom faculty will penetrate this nimitta. So sadhya, uriya, sati, samadhi, pinya. So sadhya and pinya must be valid. If sadhya is very strong, pinya, wisdom faculty is very weak. They will believe in vain activities, useless, meaningless activities. But when wisdom faculty is very strong, sadhya is very weak, they will criticize a lot to others. So criticize, they will criticize only, they will do nothing. So because of this reason, sadhya and wisdom faculty must be balanced. Then again, uriya and effort. Uriya effort and concentration samadhi must be present. So when concentration is very strong, laziness will appear. When effort is very strong, restless will appear. So they must balance. So if the five controlling faculties are balanced, you can attain jhana. Maybe anytime you can review, while walking also you can review, but this is occasionally only. If you review always, then your concentration also will decrease. Reviewing is when there is any problem only. But in this case, four protected meditations are very important. If attachment becomes very strong, one practicing samatha or one practicing vipassana, at that time you must practice asubha formless meditation, asubha bhavana. You see, asubha bhavana, there are two types of asubha. anime asubha ni is anime asubha. Sawunyanaga asubha, sawunyanaga asubha. Anime asubha, sawunyanaga asubha means to review that you was a body. Both internally and externally. This is also one type of asubha meditation, calmness meditation. Then, awunyanaga asubha. Anime asubha means dead body. You should try to see that body, and then you should practice asubha formless meditation. You can attain kanchana. So, while practicing samatha or vipassana, if there is any attachment, is very strong. Other than if you practice this asubha meditation, then that attachment will decrease. This is one method. Then, Meja bhaveta bhajavada sabhanaya. When practicing samatha or vipassana, if you have a lot of anger, then you should practice metta meditation up to jhana stage, metta jhana. Then that metta jhana will destroy this anger. So then, when practicing samatha or vipassana, if you have a lot of problem, I can do, they cannot do. So such type prop, then you can practice anicca sinya bhavetava asmimana samukhataya. I, in this way you have a lot of prop. Such type of, to suppress this such type of prop, you must practice anicca sinya. But this is for vipassana meditators only. If you are practicing vipassana, you can see ultimate materiality, ultimate mentality, both internally and externally, past, present, and future. Other than you must contemplate it as anicca, dukkha, anatta. One contemplate it as anicca. As long as they pass away very, very quickly, this mentality and materiality. So they are anicca impermanent. Other than you will not see I. Because they are mentality and materiality, as well as they perish away. So there is no time to tell this is I, this is I, this is I. So if you have a lot of prop, you must practice this anicca sinya. So these are very important. Sometimes you have no completion, no much faith. Faith is very weak. Other than you must try recollection of Buddha's qualities, Buddha knows it. Sometimes you have no samvega, sense of spiritual urgency. Then you want to enjoy with sensual pleasure. Other than you should try varnanusti, recollection of your own death. So these are also very important. So because of this reason, in Asian times, every meditator must practice number one, metta, number two, Buddha dosti, recollection of Buddha's quality, number three, asubha, formless meditation, number four, varnasati, recollection of their own death. They are four project meditation.
Regarding the five jhana factors today, Sierra mentioned that we need to get out from jhana to review the five jhana factors. So when we get out from the jhana, what level of concentration is there that is used to review the five jhana factors?
And then the excess concentration. In the we got excess concentration, but out of concentration. But that reviewing mind is similar to vipassana. Vipassana inside. As soon as they emerge, if they quickly review, we call this is one type of vipassana. They can see this kind of matter. This is the method mentioned in the Anugraha Sutta. In Anugraha Sutta, Venerable Sariputta, practice vipassana by way of Anubhuta. Anubhuta means in contemplating jhana dhammas one by one, systematically. For example, he re-established his phajjana concentration. When he emerged from phajjana concentration, he contemplated jhana dhammas one by one. For example, here, 34, we just explained. Consciousness, channel consciousness, nature, pasa consciousness, nature, vrana, feeling is nature, in this world, one by one, he do. If he cannot do, then he re-establish vajana again. And imagine from vajana, he again review this. This is reviewing knowledge as well as vipassana. No question? Okay, let's just stop the questions. Tomorrow we'll be back.